AI is going to take over the world in 2021. Well, we are not there yet, Skynet.
Hasta la vista, baby.
But AI can certainly help VR filmmakers to save money and create silky smooth 60 frames per second VR video for the latest Oculus Quest 2 VR headset. You don't need a $15,000 VR camera to get 60 frames per second. You can shoot with the ONE X2, ONE R or GoPro Max and get 6K 60 frames per second 60 video as you're watching it right now. You can't see the result unless you silo the video onto your Oculus Quest 2. So find the video download link in the description down below, silo it onto your Quest 2 using SideQuest and watch the magic happen. If you want to learn the post-production AI magic absolutely free, well, keep watching. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator, bringing you the absolutely free way. Let me rewind. Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, bringing you another fresh VR filmmaking tutorial that you can't find anywhere else. So, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you can be ahead of the game. This time, I'm collaborating with GRIS AI, the creator developer behind the famous DAINAPP AI. In the 2021 alpha release, the AI app is going to support high resolution 260 or VR 180 video. As you all know by now, cinematic VR video look great in 60 frames per second in the Oculus Quest 2 VR headset. If you don't know the max resolution and frame rate of the Quest 2, you should watch my Oculus Quest 2 review right here. Now, let me show you how to use AI to interpolate 360 videos. Before we start, make sure your source video is in the highest resolution in ProRes or CineForm if you are using GoPro Max. For ONE X2 or ONE R, you can use the Insta360 Studio 2021 desktop app to render out ProRes file. MP4 files are compressed and you will lose quality. If you don't know this, you should really check out my 360 VR filmmaking masterclass link right here. In the masterclass, I will explain the best rendering workflow for any VR or 360 camera in detail. The AI app requires a NVIDIA graphic card, sorry AMD, and you should have at least 8 gigabit of video RAM. But ideally, you should have 12 to 24 gig VRAM. I have the NVIDIA Titan RTX, but I would recommend getting the 3090 RTX. This AI app will use 100% of your fancy GPU resources, make your investment well worth it. Download the free app on GRIS AI Patreon page, link down below. Please support the creator because they work hard so you can save money. Unzip your download and just run the exe file right here. If you want a Mac version, you should comment down below. Input file, pick the ProRes MOV file. The output folder is whatever. The important step is here. Pay attention. Go to Interpolation, the second tab. Make sure the AI app is using your GPU card. I have the Titan RTX, as you see right here. Type in 1 instead of -1. If not, you will run into our memory error. 24 gigabyte of memory will never run out if you have the 3080 or 3090 RTX. Set your output frame rate. You can try 3x to get 90 frames per second if you are feeling crazy, but 60 frames per second in general is more than enough. Then right here, I like to set to 0 with no compression PNG sequence. The app will generate a MP4 video for you as well, but we want the best image quality, so we only care about the PNG, not the MP4. If you are low in hard drive space, you can check this option right here to skip the PNG sequence entirely. Hit Perform All Step Render button and wait. The new version RIFE app is a lot faster than the DAINAPP app.
Since we are still in alpha of the RIFE app, I will recommend open up test managers to check GPU memory usage. As you see right here, when render kick in, the GPU memory usage jump all the way to 11GB at 60%. If you are low on GPU memory, make sure to kill any application that use your GPUs. This is an 8K360 video. If you do not have a high spec GPU, I would highly recommend stay within 5.7K for the ONE X2 or even lower like 4K. If you get a 4K playing in 60 frames per second on Oculus Quest 2, it is still a lot better than most of the video out there. Since you are generating PNG sequence, if in any point your memory runs out, just start a new render from when you left off.
Now, instead of importing the MP4 file, you import the PNG image sequence into Premiere. Right click in the project window, import, go to the PNG folder and select the first image. Make sure you check the image sequence and OK.
After importing the PNG sequence, make sure you right click on the sequence, modified, interpolate footage, assume this frame rate to 59.97 to make this image sequence into 60 frames per second. Then you are done.
Here is a render on red Komodo fisheye VR 180 footage. It does generate some artifacts if your subject is moving very fast and there is a busy background also moving behind the subject, as you see right here. But the AI is doing a pretty good job. Here is the result using ReVision Twixtor, another famous After Effects plugin to slow down video. The result is not as good as the AI. Well, to be fair, the correct way to use Twixtor is to use Pro version and create a vector path with rotoscoping to key out the subject. I have a tutorial coming up to get you the absolute best result. Better than the AI for sure, but if you don't have the Twixtor, the free AI solution is not that bad at all. Thank you for watching. To support me to bring you the latest tips and tricks in VR filmmaking, VR camera review, and immersive video content, please give me a big thumb up, share this video on your social media, and drop me a thank you comment down below. Not like other YouTubers, I usually respond like a real human being, not AI. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell right here for more cool tutorials just like this one. And I will see you next time. Stay creative, my friends.